Hey everybody, what's up? It is Wednesday, July 15th. All right, a lot of stuff to talk about today. It's tax day. Tax day, yes, and that is very important. I've been looking over the numbers and the tax flows are rolling in. Now, as you know, I've been talking about these tax flows up until now as a barometer of economic activity. I wanted to see a pickup in the tax flows to kind of substantiate or corroborate what we're hearing in the data or what we're seeing in the data in terms of an economic pickup. I mean, that would justify the market moving higher. Now, we did see that in the corporation income tax flows. You know, they were picking up a little bit in the post-lockdown period. And again, we have, you know, new closures happening, but I'll set that aside for the moment. The employment and withholding tax flows, they've been weak. They keep going down on a year-over-year basis. They're also weak compared to the post-lockdown period compared to the pre-lockdown period. But now, because taxes are due and payable now, remember, those tax payments, those tax liabilities were deferred back in March when we had all the stimulus programs and they said, you know, Mnuchin said, hey, you don't have to file your taxes until July 15th. Well, they're due now. So we got to look at these tax payments in a completely different way. I mean, taxes, nobody likes to pay taxes for good reason. I mean, they take away income, they take away savings. I mean, so there was this huge trillions, literally, in deposits and bank deposits. A lot of that money was sitting there because taxes were not paid, but now they're getting paid. So that is taking away that income and savings, all right? That is like the equivalent, the fiscal equivalent of a massive spending cut. Just to let you know how much that year-over-year gap has narrowed in the last couple of weeks, tax deposits to the Treasury were down $211 billion compared to last year, just 2 weeks ago. They're down only $150 billion now. So we have seen a $60 billion narrowing. What does that mean? It means $60 billion in income, savings, deposits, if you will, have been taken out of the economy and sent over to the Treasury. Now, I think this is going to have a negative impact on the economy. We're in a recovery period right now, but these tax flows, these tax payments, and you know, I said this all the way back in March. I said that we're probably in a rebound period because of the fiscal support and the monetary support. I said we're probably going to be in a rebound period until July when those tax payments are due. And they're due now. The flows are happening. So you got to keep an eye on that. Now, apart from that, we got the weekly EIA petroleum weekly status report today. Interesting thing in there. Gasoline demand dropped by 118,000 barrels per day. That was the biggest decline in 2 months. So that might be another sign that this new round of closures starting to affect people, maybe going to their jobs, commuting, whatever. Gasoline demand took the biggest decline in 2 months. We also saw refiner inputs. That's refiner inputs of crude. That also dropped it was the first decline in 2 months. So a couple of things in that data that maybe we could look at, which would be kind of an early sign or some early evidence that these new closures are starting to have a negative impact. So you got the tax data now, a lot, you know, people having to pay their taxes, writing checks to the government. That's, you know, the balance in their checking account and the deposits reduced. It's not a good thing. As everybody knows, nobody likes to pay taxes. And, you know, for good reason, that's the reason. You see your bank account drop way down. So that's happening right now. And maybe some signs in the petroleum data, at least on the demand side, that things are starting to weaken up a little bit. So market's still looking strong. It's running on a lot of momentum right now, but the impact of these new things may very likely be negative. And if so, we will start to see the market pull back here. We're into bank stocks right now. I spoke about this in my last video. Had some positive numbers in the banking data recently. Bank stocks look attractive on a valuation basis. Hey, I want to mention that the new episode of my podcast is out right now. You can go there, just click on the link in the description below. And of course, go to my website, pitbulleconomics.com. By the way, you can also listen to the podcast at pitbulleconomics.com. Just click on the tab that says podcast. And don't forget to sign up for a 30-day free trial of MMT Trader. See everybody tomorrow. Bye-bye.